ओके, ए वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल मैथ्स विद मांति सर। चिल्ड्रन, टुडे लेट अस डिस्कस फ्यू प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन द चैप्टर योर पेयर ऑफ लीनियर इक्वेशंस इन टू वेरिएबल। ऑलरेडी इन द नॉर्मल क्लास थ्योरी क्लास वी हैव ऑलरेडी रेड एवरीथिंग, वी नो हाउ टू सॉल्व ए पेयर ऑफ लीनियर इक्वेशंस इन टू वेरिएबल। इट हैज व्हाट इनफाइनाइट, इट मे हैव ए पेयर और ए सिस्टम, इट मे हैव इनफाइनाइटली मेनी सोल्यूशन, इट मे हैव ए यूनिक सोल्यूशन, इट मे हैव नो सोल्यूशन, एंड फॉर नो सोल्यूशन इनफाइनाइटली मेनी सोल्यूशन एंड योर व्हाट यूनिक सोल्यूशन, व्हाट आर द कंडीशंस वी हैव ऑलरेडी रेड। सो लेट अस अप्लाई द कॉन्सेप्ट, लेट अस अप्लाई अवर अंडरस्टैंडिंग टू ए पर्टिकुलर प्रॉब्लम which is generally coming in the class 10 CBSE board examination. I have taken one problem. See, suppose the question is, you are given a pair of linear equations, say kx minus y equal to 2, this is one equation, 6x minus 2y equal to 3, it is another linear equation in two variable. That means here you are given a pair, and you know a pair of equation is known as system, okay. Now the question is, here is k, look at k is some constant, it is the coefficient of x, we do not know what is the value of k. So the question is, find k, means find the value of k. The condition is what? Such that, or for which, this system will have a unique solution or no solution, you see. That means for what value of k this system has unique solution and no solution. Two bits. Now what is the third bit? The third bit is there a value of k? Means, is there any value of k? Can we find the value of k such that this system will have infinitely many solutions? Let us discuss all the steps in detail, okay? See, now the first case is unique solution. We have to find the value of k in this system or a given pair of linear equation. We have to find the value of k such that the condition is the system will have unique solution. So what is the condition for a system of equations to have a unique solution? You know, the condition is, you see, for unique solution, what is the condition? I hope you must have remembered. The condition is a1 by a2 not equal to b1 by b2. This is the condition. This condition must be satisfied by a system to have a unique solution. See, unique means one and only one solution. Okay. Now, what is the value of a1? It is k. See, what is the value of a2? It is 6. K by 6 not equal to minus 1 by minus 2, which is equal to 1 by 2. Then, k by 6 not equal to this 6. 6 into 1 by 2, it is 3. That means you see 3. Therefore, k not equal to 3, look at k not equal to 3. That means if the value of k is not equal to 3, then only the system will have a unique solution. That means for any value of k other than 3, the given system will have a unique solution. Okay? Now come to the second bit. No solution. What will be the value of k so that the system will have no solution? Let us see how to find out. For no solution, see, what is the condition? For no solution, for a system or a pair of linear equations to have no solution, what is the condition? The condition is, I hope you must have remembered, it is a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 not equal to c1 by c2. See, this condition must be satisfied by a system so that it will have a what? It will have no solution. Okay, now let us put the value. You see. Okay. Now first find the value of b1 by b2. See. Now, what is the value of b1 by b2? Find out. b1 by b2, it is minus 1 by minus 2, it is 1 by 2. Now find c1 by c2. It is clearly 2 by 3. Now look at. b1 by b2 is 1 by 2 and c1 by c2 is 2 by 3. Are they equal? The answer is clearly no. That means, therefore, we say that b1 by b2 is not equal to c1 by c2. Okay. Now, b1 by b2 not equal to c1 by c2 we got. Then, what is the condition? If b1 by b2 is not equal to c1 by c2, then, in order that the system will have no solution. What condition must be satisfied? Definitely A1 by A2 not equal to B1 by B2. I repeat my sentence statement again. See, if B1 by B2 not equal to C1 by C2, it has been established. Now, if B1 by B2 not equal to C1 by C2, then in order that the system will have no solution, what condition must be satisfied? Definitely A1 by A2 equal to B1 by B2. Therefore, so what will be my next step? Our next step will be, therefore, for no solution, in this case, for no solution, you see, as B1 by B2 not equal to C1 by C2, which has already been established, therefore, A1 by A2 must be equal to B1 by what? B2. If B1 by B2 is not equal to C1 by C2, then for no solution, as we want to, in order that the system will have no solution, then A1 by A2 must be equal to B1 by B2. Now you put the value, A1 by A2 it is K by 6, equal to B1 by B2 is minus 1 by minus 2, which is equal to 1 by 2. That means K will be equal to 6 by 2, that is 3, you see. Therefore, you see, K equal to 3. That means for K equal to 3, if the value of K is 3, then only the given system, this particular given system or pair of linear equations will have no solution, okay? So in the first case, what did we see, children? We saw that for K not equal to 3, see, if K is not equal to 3, means for any value of K other than 3, the system will have what? A unique solution. And in the second case, we saw that if K is 3, then only the system will have what? No solution, okay? Now let us come to the third point. The third part of this question, what does it ask? It asks us, is there a value of K, means is there any K for which the system has infinitely many solutions? That means, can we find any value of K for which the system will have what? Infinitely many solutions. So how to do this part? See, for that we have to remember what is the condition required for a system to have infinitely many solutions. I hope you must have remembered what is that. It is A1 by A2 equal to B1 by B2 equal to C1 by C2. If this condition is satisfied, then we say that a system has infinitely what? Many solutions. Okay, let us find out then. See, for many solutions, see the third part, the last part. For infinitely many solutions, what is the condition? The condition is A1 by A2 equal to B1 by B2 equal to C1 by C2. This is the condition to be satisfied by a system so that it will have infinitely many solutions. Okay? Now see, here, what is the value of B1 by B2? Already we have found B1 by B2, it is 1 by 2 and C1 by C2, what is the value? C1 by C2 is 2 by 3. So clearly, B1 by B2 not equal to C1 by C2. Okay? Now see, B1 by B2 and C1 by C2, they are not equal. Now the point is, if you take any value of K, you see, whatever be the value of K, this condition will not be satisfied. This condition, A1 by A2 equal to B1 by B2 equal to C1 by C2. That means, you see, A1 by A2, see, after this we can write, you see, A1 by A2, what is the condition? K by 6. B1 by B2, what is the condition? It is 1 by 2. And C1 by C2, what is the value? 2 by 3. Now see, here we proved that B1 by B2 not equal to C1 by C2. Now, the point is, see, you take any value of K, whatever value, positive, negative, okay? Whatever the value of K may be, whatever value of K we may assign, maybe positive value, maybe negative value, this equality will not be satisfied, or this condition will not be satisfied. So what does it mean? It means, for no value of K, this will be satisfied. If for no value of K, this equation is satisfied, then that means we cannot find any value of K for which the system will have what? Infinitely many solutions. So what will be our next step? You see, our next step will be Our next step will be for no value of k, or whatever the value of k may be, whatever k may be, a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 equal to c1 by c2 will not be satisfied. You see, that means whatever the value of k may be, this condition will not be satisfied. And if this condition is not satisfied, that means there is no k. There is no k for which k. There is no k for which this system will be satisfied. Okay, this system will have infinitely many solutions. Children, I hope you understood how to find the value of k if you are given a system of equations and the condition is given whether it has unique solution or no solution or many solution. How to get the value of k in this particular problem that I discussed. I hope children you must have understood. If at all it is true, please hit the like button and subscribe my channel. Okay, so we shall discuss more problems from this chapter in the next class. Thank you.